Today, we should continue with our listing for posts, and after that, show a specific post on a custom, let's say, show page. But hey, if you are new to this channel, I'm Peter, and I upload 1 to 3 videos weekly about web development. If that sounds interesting to you, subscribe. Unfortunately, because we forgot to commit our changes last time, we should start by doing that, and after that we continue with what we wanted to do today. So let's hit Ctrl K on PHP Store, and let me think what we did. Well, we add simple listing for published posts. And let's commit. And it's taking a while. But yeah. Okay. So we should start after that, of course. Basically, we already started. But let's run our server in a terminal, PHP artisan serve. And going to localhost 8000. We have our posts from our last time. Let's log in. Actually, do we need to log in? No. Here we don't need any pagination, but we need pagination on, let's say, slash posts. And here we have the same two because we fetched the latest 5 on homepage, but here we fetch all of them, all of published ones. And let's minimize this terminal because it's annoying. What do we need to do here? Well, going to our posts.blade.php, we should put links in our row. So for example, we need posts links. I think it was the method for templates. But we don't have any. Let's change the pagination from our get all public posts action to be, I don't know, 1, to see if the pagination it is working. And it is, but of course it's not where we want it. But it is working. Let's put it in a div. So, sorry, let's leave this a moment. Going to post.blade.php. Let's put, oh my god, this is bad. We should put it after the for each. Okay, and let's put a div to wrap it. What? Oh, my bad. We need to put it here after the row because since it is Bootstrap 4, it has a display flex. Okay, this is good. Let's change back to 25 pagination default, and we don't have any. Oh, it's page 2. We don't end this. Okay, cool. That's actually pretty cool. Let's do. We have 2 issues here. First of all, we don't have any option and any route, of course, to click and go to a post details, and we should do that today. But we have duplicate code on our views. For example, check out blog posts, and let's see home. This section here, this for each, it is basically the same with this one. Of course, the post links, but here it is what the columns, the post thumbnails. So what I want to do it is to create, let's say, I don't know, includes, for example, a directory in views includes. And here, let's create a new, let's say, I'm not sure if we have any blade option here. Anyway, what it is a post thumbnail. So post thumbnail. Actually, with dash posts, it is a single post thumbnail.blade.php. And let's put the duplicate code that I meant. So for example, let's put the card. Do we need the card or... Yeah, the card, it's okay. Let's put it like that. Actually, let's copy it first. Put it here. And looks alright. And here, instead of doing that, this is posts blade. So, include. We need includes dot post thumbnail. And we need to send an array. So for example, with the key being the variable from the include template and our value. So we need to send the post and it should be post. And still working. But right now we can take this and use it on our home. So instead of doing that, we should do that. And going to home, it's still working. So that's pretty cool and reduce our even more our HTML. Good. So right now, if we add one, let's say link here, for example, we need to wrap on our includes post thumbnail. Let's say that whenever we click this card, we should go to a route. For example, I'm not sure. Let's go to, actually, we don't have any route right now, so let's do that. First of all, let's, how we do that? Let me think a bit. Okay, going to our that web.php, actually, yeah, web.php. What we need it is something like that. Route get, of course, we need the posts slash. And here we need to put a slug, for example, here, let's say post slug. And after that, we need to fetch the posts by slug. So for example, let public post control, it's okay. It should be a show because we want to show a post. And public posts, public show. Post show, I'm not sure how to name this. Let's say public.show. Pretty weird with that notation, but it grew on me. Okay, so going to public posts controller, we need to add a method show. Public function show. It's a best practice to keep the controllers with the same 4 or 5. I don't remember the number now, but it is index, show, create, store, edit, update, and delete, or destroy, depending on what you prefer. So show, let's DD something here. Post. Actually, let's put the slug here, since we have the post slug. So, post slug. Sorry, it should be the post slug. Okay, and let's check the route. So for example, if you go to post slash something, it's working. Of course, it's working just the route. We need to actually use it. So we need to create an action because we have only actions. We need to create an action on our posts that retrieves a post by its slug. So get public post by slug. It should be the name, of course. So new PHP class. How we did? Get public post by slug. Looks good. Let's put the constructor. And public function run. And we need to get the slug, of course. So, run slug, that's okay, and after that, what we should do, well, we need to return post we have multiple options. We can do it like that, where slug and we should do first to get the first by slug. If we do that, let's test this out first. So going to our posts public posts controller show method, let's inject the get by slug. Okay, and let's say post equals sorry about this, post get public post run by post slug. Okay, and let's DD the post. So let's see what happens if we put something. Oh, we had the post with this slug. Cool. So slug, it is this one. That's neat. But what if we put something that we don't have? For example, this one. It's null. We need to have a 404. So it shows the user that we don't have any post with that slug. So let's go to post by slug and let's say first or fail. And right now we have a 404, but if we go to AESD, whatever, it's okay. And that's pretty cool. Going to again to post control public post controller. Here we need to return a view, which you don't have yet. So let's do that. And let's create a view because you don't have any, a dummy one for the moment, it's okay. So here we can have, let's say, post.blade.php. And let's copy whatever we have here. Okay. We don't have multiple posts. And we don't have any pagination here since we have only one. And let's put, for the moment, let's put the DD for post. Going to public post controller. Let's return the view. So blog.post. And width, since we have multiple, we need to send something. We should send the post and get public post by slug run. By post slug. Actually, it's okay. So, yeah. Pretty good. Let's check it out. So, okay. It is working. Let's test it out, actually. So, going to post. Let's put instead of DD, let's put in, let's say H1. Let's put the post title. And let's remove this. Okay, pretty good. I really like it. Okay, so right now we have our post. If we do something weird, it's sending us to 404 not found. And that's good. We can override that page and we'll do it later a little bit. Not today, of course. And we need to add a link to our cards. And since we have that include, we can do it here. And we do that by using the helper route. But let me see where. Okay, we can wrap the whole card or just the name. For the moment, let's do it with the card instead of the name. Let's put, for example, href. Let's move this inside, and for the moment now we have a link here, so going that, that's okay. And let's use it. So route, Laravel has a route helper which takes a route name, and what was the name? Going to web.php, it is public post show, and we need to send a post slug. So for example, if you have only one param, on the URL, we don't have to specify the name, but if we had to, we should put an associative array and with the names. I will show it maybe later if we need it. So going to post, let me see. Sorry, post slug. And doing that, it shows us already that we send it to post updated, going back with the name, and if we put something else here, 404 not found. But of course, we have a bug right now because we forgot that we need only the published ones. Because if it wasn't published, let's first remove this. We'll put it again later and test it out. Login. Programming with Peter.com and password. I wanted to show it to you. So for example, this one is public. It is. This one, it is public. It isn't. So going, let's take this. Ah, it was already working. So we have done a slug for a post that wasn't public and we could see it, which is not okay. But taking this slug, so for example, going to localhost 8000 and / posts and the slug post updated. But if we put it only HDHD, it should not work, and it is working. Let's put the published scope here, and it gives us a 404 not found. If we publish the post, so if we publish this one, refreshing, it should work again, and we now have three cards. That's cool. So going to / posts, clicking, I'm not sure why it has to, oh, it had a cache. So clicking one of this is going to do this, and that's okay. Good. Now we have this. Let's commit our changes and let's say create. We have multiple ones actually. Add, include for post card, and we created add action for single for getting post by slug. Let's commit the changes. That's good. Okay, so another thing that we need to do here, it is to display it. Let's say we need to create some public, let me see. We need to work a bit on our design here because we can't see anything, and we should display more on our more than. So for example, we have to do a div with class content or whatever, but here let's see if we can text white so we can read something. Okay, so we added on our row text white. So here let's put the post content like that, so we can see the content. I'm not sure this here, we don't need the row class because we don't have any cards. We can have, for example, here on H1 text center to center the title, and the content, it should be on. Actually, the content should have a row wrapper, and after that, a call MD, let's say 12, no, not 12, 8, and move this, let me see, and here, let's put another call with 4. And let's say sidebar. Okay. That's okay. I like it. So right now we have our post displayed here with a lot of content. Going to different ones, it will show different content. Hopefully we didn't write, okay, we didn't write on each of them dummy data. And that's good. I don't really like the design here, but we'll change it a little bit later. Let's commit again our changes. So, for example, let's say add, actually change single post layout. Of course, this is not done, but before continuing with our design, we need to change the quill so it accepts a little bit more, let's say, images, tables, code, because right now it is pretty empty. If we go to admin/post and edit, okay, I'm not sure why my PC got slow a little bit, but anyway, it doesn't do much. It has a font, an H1, a bold, italic, and underline, and simple stuff. So we need to create, to make it a little more, let's say, powerful. And of course, we need to put the SEO stuff on our single post page. But we'll do that on the next episode. Thank you for watching, and if you like this video, please subscribe, leave a like, and comment, even if you have something bad to say about these videos. I would love to hear it and improve it on it. It helps me to get better and maybe help others.